your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here. Hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Ark Survival Evolved, Pooping Evolved server, just having a morning over here. Me and Gameplay been hanging out. That's right, man, doing stuff and things, just cooking up some food, getting ready for the day. You know, stuff and things are about to happen, peeps. This video, hopefully, depending on when the biome update comes out, will be before the biome update. And this whole area is probably going to go bye-bye or be changed in a very drastic way. And it's I think some people are a little bit sad about it, but really most of the people on the server are kind of excited to see what happens. And we're just psyched to like be able to do like more stuff and things. Like, honestly, it is one of those things where, and I bet a lot of people are having an issue with this on different servers where, like, you know, it's kind of a bummer that your buildings might get destroyed and stuff like that if you happen to be building in a swamp biome or in the new biome, with the new snowy biome, which is going to be actually in the northeastern area up by where we had our base last season. But I look at it really as kind of, I don't know, I'm excited. I want to see the new biomes. I want to see, like, how, what everything's going to be looking like. And I'm excited to build again. And it's going to be really, really fun. So, yeah, a few things that I wanted to do today. Oh, I want to say thank you guys so much for all your support in the Ark videos, as I always do. It really does mean a lot to me. I really, really do appreciate it. So thank you guys so much for slamming and smashing and killing the like button for me. If you guys like this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe for more Ark stuff and things as well. Today, there's a couple things. We're always on the lookout for a really high-level Dimetapodon. And we're also going to be looking for a high-level T-Rex around. But also today wanted to do some scouting. Because eventually, like, we have our building, our little house over at Poop City. We're definitely not going to be leaving Poop City behind, even with the biome update. It's still going to be a thing for sure. We're still going to be doing stuff and things over here. But we are eventually going to be building into a new area. So I want to kind of get a look for a new base type place. Now, was talking before about down below at around 80 latitude, 20-ish longitude. There's those waterfalls that are down there. And I don't think that that's actually somewhere I'm going to build. Because this season, I want to build somewhere that's a little more centrally located. And one of the things about Ark, and it's a little bit, well, it's kind of a bummer, is that there are so many awesome places on the southern coast to build, right? Really, really cool and amazing places down there that look so great. And I am never going to build down there because they're so far away from all of the resources, and that being mostly, when I say all of the resources, I really do mean metal. Like, metal is, you know, super important thing to have, and you don't want to have a lot of it. And since there really just isn't a lot of it down there, it doesn't really make any sense for us to do our building down there. So, like I was saying, I want to scout out a location for a base that's not in that area. Also, today we're on the lookout for some female Argentavis. We want to go ahead and get some of those going for the kibble farm. Argentavis, we don't have any Argentavis over at the kibble farm now, or I think we have one that Mazion brought over, but not a lot. So that's something that I want to take a look at as well. But we're flying over right now to the first place that I was kind of thinking about starting to look at base locations. I really don't know. I do want to try to find somewhere that's somewhat flat. I am looking for like a flat area and a large flat area where I can house a lot of dinos. Oh, what's up? Good morning, raptors! Oh, so unfortunate for you! All right, so one of the things I was taking a look at is down in this area here. I think we do have, where is it? There's some metal deposits. Let's take a look down inside of here and see what we can see. There's a lot of stone. We got a lot of different obsidian down here, which isn't bad. But really, I'm looking for metal. All right, so there's some metal right there. I want to be somewhere where I can take hardware, our new Parasaur, and bring him over and just be able to walk up and kind of harvest a lot of metal. Now, up here, along the pathway to the, let me gamma down a little bit for you guys, up here to the pathway that goes up to the volcano, there is some, but I don't know if we'll be able to get a Parasaur up here. Probably not, I'm going to take a wild guess and say. But this is one of the spots I was trying to think about and take a look at as being a good spot for metal. So, all right, it doesn't look like there's quite as much as I thought there was. I mean, there is some in and about the area here. There's some metal. Oh, maybe. Oh, let's fly down here and take a look at what this area looks like. So where are we going to be if we're over here? Oh. This is not bad. This is really near the Chitin Cave. So this is really close to the Chitin Cave, which I do believe is right over into this really direction. Where are we? Let me see here. If we fly up here, the Chitin Cave is right over here. All right. See it right there? So if we come down here, you'll be able to see it. Oh, and there's metal all around in this area, too. What are you, red thing? Alpha something! What level are you? Oh, 70? I don't know. I don't know if we can take him. Let's play around with it for a second and see what happens. Oh, he's not really hurting us. Oh, Spum's guy died. All right. Let's turn around here. Let's get a better angle. Oh, yeah. We're killing it. We're going to kill it. I hope. We'll see. Furiously clicking. We're about half health. Oh, we're hurt. All right, we got to come up. Let us remote use item. You know, I really want to write like a macro or something so that I can force feed my bird a little bit faster. Let's get back up to at least half health. We were really low there. Well, we'll just eat all this right here, and we'll eat this last one too and see what we can do. Oh, yeah, eat the food. All right, where is he? Squirt back down. All right, here we go. We're coming in for another pass. Where were you just like, was he like stunned? He was just by stunned. He was like retrospectively looking back on the experience that he had just had, and he was just scared out of his wits. Oh, die. You're so close. No. All right, we got to get out. We got to eat the rest of our meat. We're really close. We're really close to being able to take this guy. You know, it might not be a bad idea. He's a level 70. I'd hate to pump too much. We could pump another point of health or something like that. And I'm just going to eat all the meat we've got. Just to see. How much does that take us up to? Oh, we're so close to being able to kill this guy. Anything around here really quickly I could get some meat from? All right. I'm going to try it. Oh, yeah. We got you, man. Give me your meat immediately. Immediately? Get it immediately? Oh, no. Where'd the raptor go? No, Alpha Raptor. No, Alpha Raptor. Oh, yeah, baby. Took a second, but we got him finally. Did we get any amazing stuff and things? So we got the bone skin helmet, and we got a level. Speaking of HPs, 3,600. So that pumps us up quite a bit. It looks like we got a level, too. You got anything amazing in your inventory there, homie? No. All right, so he doesn't have anything amazing in there, and we didn't gain... Oh, apprentice hide boots. We got to save those for Zul'jin. So that's not a bad find right there either. All right, so we got that guy. But back to what we were talking about. Oh, let me go ahead and grab my inventory. I'm going to start pumping weight again. I'm having some trouble with that lately. So anywho, what we were talking about before, we were interrupted by our amazing XP gathering Alpha Raptor battle extraordinaire, is the Chitin Caves right here. Now, I didn't even know, but it looks like these guys have already set some stuff and things up over here. Let's head inside and see what we can see. It's a little bit dark. Oh, and we're loading the cave, and we've loaded the cave. So it looks like Menace has got a guy over here, Mittens, 181, and then we've got Nipple Curious. I don't have any idea who that would be. And we got some beds over here, too. And a little bit of Chitin hanging out over there. So this cave, being close to it, is not a bad thing at all, because then we can come and get Chitin all day long. It's going to be a little bit of loading lag while we come back in here. Oh, no. Pulmonal Scorpius, you think you're going to do something? Yeah, you're not. All right. So we're going to need some more meat here. Eventually, if we see something easy, we'll take it out. We're really, really low on HPs. And I'm sure gameplay is not having a good time right now. But the next thing that we wanted to see was, so we got the Chitin Cave there. Where is there an area that's somewhat flat and not too far away from stuff and things? I'm going to take a look around, guys, and then I'll BRBs. And we're back, ladies and gentle peeps. I've been doing some scouting, but right in front of us, right there, is a 112th level Dimetapodon. I feel like this could be quite an interesting little encounter. I'm not really sure how this is all going to work out. I'm just going to try to get as close to it as I can. We're going to get off of here. Whistle passive. Let's get this bad boy out. And this might... I don't know how much it's going to take him to get him down. I don't want to kill him. I don't have a lot of experience with taming Dimetapodons, to be honest with you. Oh, wow. Oh, we're hurt, man. Holy crap. Oh, crap, crap, crap. Don't kill us, man. Where are you? Where are you? Oh, wow. Really hurt. Nope. Oh, wow. He packs a punch. Did it get him? He's down. He's down. He's down. Oh, man. So cool. All right. All right. So, we got to get... First things first, I'm never going to be able to find this guy again. So, I'm going to make a standing torch to start with. And then I'm just going to go around and probably just get some prime meat. Do the regular stuff and things like, you, like you're used to doing. Let me go ahead and craftables. No, wait, whatever. I'll make a standing torch. And then we're going to get him tamed up. I'm so psyched. This is going to be so cool. All right, BRBs, peeps. I can't believe it, man. I can't believe it. This RG just flew in. I was just making the standing torch. And this RG just flew in and he damaged the Dimorphodon. I can't believe it. I know he hit him. God, crap. Oh, that stinks so much. So he's going to lose taming effectiveness. His health isn't that bad. Oh, it's unconscious levels almost. He's almost not conscious. He's almost conscious, I said. Holy crap. I think I have some Medjos. Remote use item. Just to get something on him. Wow, this is turning out to be a thing. All I did was go make a foundation and a standing torch, and that was it. Did we get any prime meat off of that guy? No. All right, let's take this RG out. We got to get some prime meat on this guy and see what's going on. We need some berries right away, too. Did you give me your prime meats? All right, we got one. Oh, man, I hope this works out. We gotta move fast, man. And we're back, and we got him, man. Holy crap. I didn't even get this... It's a chance. What's his name? Holy crap. I didn't even get a chance to see, like, what the taming effectiveness or any of that was. I was so kind of flustered by him getting hit and then his unconscious level was going down so fast. And I was going to get narco berries and going to get prime meat. And, like, I just started jamming a bunch of prime meat on him. And we got it. We got him, man. He's totally baller, man. 150? Not bad at all. All right, let's chuck him. Wait, no, not Harvest Stone. No. Chuck. Get chucked, yo. Unfollow. We got to think of a great name for him. Let me go ahead and... wait. Come here. No. All right. Land, homie. Land. What is his stats? That's what we want to look at. 80 or 800 health already. 375 stamina. It's not that big of a deal. 299 melee damage. And just 100% movement speed. So I have to pump his movement speed up. Get his health up a little bit. But this guy's baller, man. Super powerful. So cool. He's going to be our best friend. He's going to be our best friend forever. And we're back. And I got him painted up. I just painted him basically all blue. And he already had like these highlights on his wings right here, which I think looks really great. And then I just did like a white stripe down the back, which I think, again, looks really great. I see a little bit of blue in there. Oh, no. We had a really great thing going on. And I think I just messed it up a little bit. Let me see if we can reverse this somehow. Oh, crap. I'll have to repaint him, basically. I'll have to just repaint him. So let's go ahead. We'll do like that. And then if we just grab this guy and go... Like so. Pretty good. Pretty good. Looks good. I like how it fades the blue into the tail there. It has a little bit of something there. It's not a perfect system yet. But anywho, so we got him. And here he is. Oh, let me gamma... Nighttime gamma for you guys. And a couple of you guys commented, I did make a mistake, and I named this guy Mordecai. And I forgot, in Borderlands 2, Mordecai is actually the guy that has Bloodwing. Bloodwing is actually the bird. And so, in this guy, we're going to name him Bloodwing. Get it, Bloodwing, because he's blue? Come here, Bloodwing. You're going to be my buddy forever now. We're going to hang out for all and ever times. You're going to be my best bud. I hope you don't die. So, all right. We were on the search for base locations. That's what we were scouting about. I've been doing some research. I've been looking online. I've been doing stuff and things. Trying to find a spot. And the thing is that the base locations that everybody likes are the ones that look the most amazing. Now, while the looking the most amazing is really neat, the getting of metal back and forth to these places is really going to be a huge pain in the butt. And the whole idea, like I was telling you guys before, is I want my mobile base to be able to kind of like move around. I want to be able to do that. We need better gammas. I want to be able to kind of like take hardware, go get metal, and have it be close enough. So like, even though I'd like to build on the southern coast, it's just no metal down there that I can that I know of. Actually, I've been looking for a metal deposits map, and I can't find one. I can't find anything that kind of shows like where all the metal is on the map. Which would be a really cool thing to have. I'm going to take a look around for it a little bit more. Before I discount the southern area completely, I do have to admit that I don't have a lot of experience with what's going on down there. So I'm going to have to fly down and just have a look. And then I'll be our bees, peeps. And we're back. And this is one of the spots, guys, that I was talking about when I was talking about just absolutely amazing locations for stuff and things. This is very, very unique spot. And, ooh, there's a Sarco down here. What level are you, homie? Level 8? That's not even a mouse on a wheel. Why do you even... You don't deserve... No, fine. You haven't done anything. Have you been bullying anybody? No, he looks fairly passive. So, this area down here, though, I mean, it just looks so unbelievably cool. All these, like, elevated mesa-ish type, small mesa-type rocks. Right over by the water over here. And just, you could just build something crazy. Like, check it out over on this area here. There's like, oh, somebody already is. Somebody's building here. All right, let's check it out. I almost just made my decision to build here, but I guess somebody's already done it. So we can't do that. Oh man, Garrett, you know what's so funny? Man, Garrett and I, great minds. He's got, some good ideas. This is a really, really great spot. So, beautiful, good choice for him for sure. There's definitely some other spots, so there's no worry there. But one of the other things is that I was saying that, and if you're wondering where we are, by the way, right here, right down in that inlet by like 55, or what would it be? Probably 85 latitude, 55 longitude, something like that, is where this area is on the map. So, I was saying also that there's absolutely no metal down here, and I was thinking that just can't be. There's got to be some somewhere. And over here on this mountain, there is actually some metal deposits. So if we were to build in this area, we could. I mean, it wouldn't be that big of a deal because right over here, there is some metal. Now, there's not a ton. Let me go over here and show you what I can see for the metal deposits that are here. And then I'll show you also of a little base location that I was thinking about right here on this giant outcropping. So right all along here would be a pretty cool spot. Let me see if I can fly away a little bit so you can see it better. Like right there on that outcropping. That'd be pretty sweet, right? I don't know. It's just a cool location. Then over here on this outcropping, there's actually a little like walkway, kind of almost like a road that comes up into it. So you can see right here, there'd be like a little road that comes up there, right inside of there. So pretty cool, pretty sweet area. Kind of neato, but anywho's, all right, I want to show you guys this metal location over here as well. So right up in here, there is all the metal. So if you did build in the south or you were thinking about it, you can get some. There's not a lot of the super high concentrated rocks in this area, but there you can see there is some metal in this area, so you could get some. Oh, there's like a little path right here too. You know, there are these little paths around sometimes. They're kind of really cool to follow and see where they're taking you because a lot of them go to like kind of neato locations. All right, so there's like a high concentration of rocks. There you can see there's metal. There's metal all through in this area right here. So you would have enough metal if you build in the south. It wouldn't be that big of a deal. And Menace has already figured it out, man. He's got a mobile smithy or mobile forge up here right now. Oh, good idea, too. He put a feeding trough on his dino so he doesn't have to. That's kind of funny considering you could just put it in the dino inventory. But it's kind of cool anyway. Does he got any metal up here? Yeah, he does, man. That's a really good idea, that he can just come around here and get all the metal he wants. Can we... Oh, yeah, let's get back on our bird. So, yeah, some of these guys, man, great minds. We're all kind of thinking the same thing. Dino Guard 1 and Dino Guard 2. Has he got Dimetapodons over here doing that for him? Yeah, it looks like that's the case. He's got some high-level Dimetapodons. All right, so I guess the search for the base location continues. I will be your bees, peeps. And we're back. Just been doing some more scouting. I thought I'd show you guys a really cool spot. Right over here by this lake. Check out these outcroppings. I'll show you where we are first. So we're right over in this early area. Like 45 latitude, 72 longitude or something like that. And Z's planning to build here. Actually, I know he is. In and around this area here. But check out all this amazing geography, like just so neat. There's like a little, you know, step right there. There's another one underneath it. It's right by this black lake. back over here, there's like another step right in front of us. It's over by Blue Tower. It's just a really cool spot for sure. He could head up to that mountain right there on flyers to get his medal. Other than that, I'm not really sure if there is any in this area. But I thought I'd come over to this side because I haven't been around here before. I've just never scouted this area, really. Look at these cool rock formations right here. Really, really neat. But yeah, over in this area, I mean, I just haven't been here before. And so I went around all the way down kind of the south and then came up the Midland area there to try to take a look at what I could see. What kind of stuff and things we got going on over here. Checking the dinos down there. Nothing I want to tame. So, yeah, but it looks like, I don't know. I really kind of can't decide. So I think the closest to the most metal is really going to be what we want to do. Now, some of you guys are probably saying, screaming, oh my God, Slipgator, build on top of the volcano. Now, I don't want to build on top of the volcano because you can't really bring big dinos up there. You know what I mean? You can't have a Brontosaurus up there. This is not a way to do that. And I really want to do that. I want to have, like, you know, I want to have cool dinos and do cool stuff with them. So I don't want to build on top of the volcano. I think that's just going to be too much. It would just be too difficult of a thing. Although, it would be pretty baller of an area to have a base. I mean, it would be pretty cool. But you just wouldn't be able to have any cool dinos up there. And that would just stink. You gotta have dinos in your base. It's Ark! What are you talking about? So I think over into this silly direction is where we're gonna head. And, we got two Rexes right down here. What's going on, Rexes? Pair of Rexes. 4 and a 44. Oh, you guys are so dead. All right. We're going to find our official spot. And then I'm going to BRB these peeps. And we're back. And I think I found it, peeps. I think I found our spot. Last season, Joe the Pirate and Midnight Designer built in this spot. And I think this is going to be our spot. Right here. I'll show you where we are. Let's go ahead and land. It's Parasaur Heaven. That's where it is. This is where all the parasaurs come and hang out, and they're so far above everything that they can't be killed by any of the bullies. All right, so we are right about a 42, a 43 latitude, and about a 65 a longitude. You can see right there. Now, some cool things about this area straight away. There's metal, huge amount of it right up here on top of this. Now, I thought about building right up on top of here, but that's just destroying, like, amazing natural resource where there's all this metal. And then when I saw this, I was like, oh, man, it would be cool. It would be baller to build up on top of that thing. Because look at it. It's just like this huge... I got to get it further away so you can kind of see for those people who don't know the area. You see, it's just like this huge mesa type deal. Huge outcropping of rock. And a base up there would look really great. But, like I was saying, you know, you're destroying all that natural resources. All that metal, baby. We need that hot metal action. So down over here... we've got a little plateau right there. We've got the big plateau up top here. Across the way, we've got a waterfall. Down over here, there's some more stuff and things. Like, there's another plateau right over there. You know, it's definitely has, like, all the potential. Potential to do some elevator stuff and things. Like, just all sorts of stuff and things. So, what I'm going to do is make a foundation and make a couple of pillars just so that I can kind of mark the area. Probably make a sign as well. And just kind of claim it. Claim the spot for the future use. Because spots, as we saw, are in short supply. There's not a lot of spots in the area. So let's go ahead and craft up. What do we need for that? Some more thatch. Give me all your thatch, please. Yes. So I'll go ahead and craft up like one of these. And then we'll do maybe a couple pillars. And yeah, I'll be our beast peeps. Okay, here we are. We're gonna put our inventory, and we're gonna go like this, and then we're gonna go like that, and we'll go like this. Nailed it. And then watch me do this amazing thing. Fine, it's not that amazing. Whatever. Don't ruin my hopes and dreams. All right. Nailed it. Ace can't be stopped. And a sign. Right here. Pretty much best placement of sign ever. Set sign text, future base location for future base location, Slipgator. Bam! Future base location, Slipgator thing has been claimed. This is going to be cool, peeps. I'm really excited. Now, just like I said, I want to say at the beginning of the episode, I said, you know, we're not going to like just leave Poop City. That's not what we're doing. But it does feel like with the amount of people we have on the server, it is kind of important that we do kind of set a claim, make a claim. And, just let people know that in the future we do want to build here. And yeah, so we can work on both things. We can work on Poop City and we can work on this. And it's going to be awesome, peeps. And we're back. And something really crazy has happened, peeps. I wanted to show you this. So I was out doing stuff and things on hardware. I was going to get some metal. And what I wanted to do was show you how amazing this was. I was like, this is going to be so amazing. I'm going to show the peeps. Could we please land? What is up with this bug? This new exiting from the birds issue is awful. Let's go ahead and get this. What do we have inside of here? So I was going to show you how amazing it was that we could. Oh, great. The dino's back. Wait, no. Gay plate. He's breaking all my stuff. Stupid Bronto. As if you came back for revenge. You were like, revenge, I have some. All right. And are we burdened or something? Okay, no. We're good to go. Look at all the destruction. Oh, my God. Everything's terrible now. I was playing around with hardware. I was going to do some experimentations, right? I was going to, like, show you this and show you that. And it was going to be pretty cool. Can we at least get rid of this body? And, the Bronto is in the way. Wow, I'm having a lot of problems right now, suddenly. The Bronto is in the way, and I decided to just attack him really quickly with gameplay. And with, like, one swipe of his little Bronto tail, it was all over for gameplay. So, didn't really think about how powerful these guys can be and how amazingly easily they can just destroy your mobile bases. These mobile bases, as far as the dinos being powerful, yeah, the dino that you have your mobile base on might be quite powerful, but the stuff and things that are on the base, man, oh man, it was easy for him to destroy this stuff. So pretty crazy. All that hard work. We're just going to drop some of this because I'm more interested in finding the metal deposits. So a couple swipes of that Bronto tail and he took out everything that we had built here. So, just you got to be really careful about that. Again, for some people, it might be a no-brainer. Some people may never have done it, so they don't really know. Let's get on gameplay. Bring him back here. You know what would be great is if you can get on a bird without having it take off. That would be sweet. Wait, what's going on now? Is there bad guys? Where are you, the bad guys? All right, let's try to do a loop here and get these packs. It's really funny that the packs actually float in the air. Can we get, like, there so we can get this guy? What do you have inside of you? 14 metal, 45 metal, 15 sparks. Oh, my gosh. You know what? I'm not even going to have the stuff and things to rebuild. That's crazy. This episode's going to go long now. Cheer! And we're back, and I got stuff and things kind of reproduced. I made a couple of changes. I didn't put the storage chests back here. I just added the refining forges back. I only put one mortar and pestle and one fire in this. And then I added a ladder. And I didn't think I was going to need the ladder that much. But just now when I was out doing stuff, just from, like, what I was doing basically was instead of bringing, like, an Anki with me or anything like that, what I was doing is just using my pick. Grabbing stuff like this, coming back over, getting on the dino this way. And then I would, like, put stuff in the forges, and then I would just hop off. Now, you hop off like this, you take a little bit of damage. If you do that 6 or 7 times in a row, like, you start to get really, really damaged. So I thought we'd put a ladder on just to make it a little bit easier. I think I'm just going to use my pick when I'm harvesting because it's such a baller pick. Like, it's an apprentice metal pick. It works really, really good. Anki's may work a little bit better, but for now, we'll have the ladder and that sort of stuff. Now, another thing that I didn't know about, and it kind of is a no-brainer, but I didn't really understand how this all worked. Like, the weight and the things that you put inside of, or on the dino, or inside of the dino, they affect the total weight of this dino. So, when I have metal and all that stuff, well, wait. I don't know. I know the metal does, basically. The stuff that I put inside of these structures, it was weighting him down. Which I didn't know if they'd built it smart enough to kind of take that into account, but they absolutely had. So, honestly, I think the Bronto's like a way better choice for this, even though it's super duper slow. In this case with us, I could just go up to the mountain right over there and do that with the Pariser, and it's probably a little bit better of an idea because he's a little bit faster, a little bit more mobile. But I think if you were going to do it for realsies, I don't know. It's such a hard call between the Bronto because he's so slow and the Parasaur because he has a little bit lower weight. But yeah, so today we turned all sorts of stuff and things. Got a new Dimorphodon. We did a whole bunch of searching for base locations, and then we destroyed our entire Parasaur Mobile Refining Forge area, and we rebuilt it. I hope you guys had a good day hanging out. I know I did. If you guys liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button.